Totalitarians, whose rule is rooted in an ideology, want obedience and conversion. The authoritarians are the guys in charge who want to stay in charge, and they don't much care about you or what you're doing so long as you stay out of their way. Live or die, it's all same to the regime. Totalitarians are a different breed. These are the people who have a plan, who think they see the future more clearly than you, or who are convinced they grasp reality in a way that you do not. They don't serve themselves, they serve history, or the people, or the idea, or some other ideological totem that justifies their actions. They want obedience, of course, but even more, they want their rule and their belief system to be accepted and self-sustaining. And the only way to achieve that is to create a new society of people who share those beliefs, even if it means bludgeoning every last citizen into enlightenment. That's what makes totalitarians different and more dangerous. They are totalistic in the sense they demand a complete reorientation of the individual to the state and its ideological ends. Every person who harbors a secret objection or even so much as a doubt is a danger to the future of the whole project. And so the regime compels its subjects not only to obey, but to believe.
I began to get into iodine a few years ago because it was helping me and my family so much get healthy and detoxify. I believe our research is conclusive. This is the best iodine out there. And I know this for a fact. Nobody else has got iodine based on these pure crystals, ladies and gentlemen.
For a limited time, experience the ancient power of Survival Shield X2.
I believe our research is conclusive. This is the best iodine out there.
Take advantage of this at InfoWarsLife.com.
And why wearing a Hillary for President t-shirt might get you punched in the face.
They thought it said Hillary for President. He said, I was seconds away from sending my bar back over here to punch you in the face. Since you're wearing a Hillary for Prison shirt, you don't have to buy drinks here. Everything's on the house.
Hillary's not surging, I tell you that. They're not saying that. They're not saying that. Thank you.
Have it. Donald Trump endorses Hillary for Prison. Get your Hillary for Prison 2016 t-shirt at the InfoWars store. And on the back it says, legalize freedom. Show your disapproval of Hillary by buying your t-shirt today.
But what she's done is criminal.
This is an American president. Just add puppet, then vote and repeat every 4 years.
InfoWars.com. I'm David Knight, and as we see from this perspective, we can see a little bit of the UN, but of course you can see a lot more of the police. The perimeter extends two blocks on either side of the road that 43rd Street that goes down to the UN, and of course you can't get any closer than 2nd Street, which is a couple of blocks away. It's a huge perimeter they put around here. Thousands and thousands of police officers. This is what it's come to. This is the total police state. But what is its ultimate objective? Its ultimate objective is not to protect one individual. Its ultimate objective is to set down a new agenda for sustainability. This is what the UN spokesmen on the news are openly saying now. UN Agenda 21, which came from this building right here to my left, that was something that was essentially kept quiet. They enacted that locally, one by one, talking about sustainability. We understand what was behind Agenda 21. That was to concentrate everyone into very confined, very concentrated cities where you have very small apartments that you live in. You're blocked from going pretty much anywhere you want to go. And of course, they're going to be using a transportation control grid to do that, because they have to basically keep you in those cities. That's going to be very easy to do once they set up the autonomous cars, the monitored highways. They're getting ready to do something that is going to be top down and very visible. It's not going to be from the bottom up like UN Agenda 21. This is going to be a top down enforced agenda. So the guy they've got to sell it, because they have to try to make some kind of a moral case for it, is going to be the Pope. And that's what's so dangerous about this. He's trying to make a moral case for global governance. That's why he's here at the UN. That's why every one of the country's leaders are here today to listen to the Pope, including Obama. That's why you have such high security. They're ready to roll out a new world government. That's what the climate change agenda is about. You have to have a way to regulate everybody. You have to have a way to tax everybody. That's why they're focusing on some kind of a global necessity to do it. And of course, they have to come out and make it sound like it is a moral case. They're losing on the scientific side, so they have to make this a moral issue. And a part of that as well is erasing international borders. The perfect storm of all of these issues comes together right here at the UN with the Pope making a case for world government later today. Stay with us. We'll be right back with more reports from InfoWars.com. I'm David Knight.
Well, if you want to understand the Pope's politics, just look at what he spoke on. Abolishing the death penalty, calling for action against global warming, demanding tolerance for immigrants. But what he wasn't very clear on, life and family. He certainly didn't call for defunding Planned Parenthood while he was there speaking in front of Congress. Now, I don't think anyone here disagrees that we should be living sustainably, but we, the people, are being blamed for everything that the people in power and those who are creating these problems, they're the ones that are creating this mess at the top, but it's being blamed on the rest of us. If you want to stop mass migration, well, stop creating the conditions that are at its core. If you want to save the environment, maybe check the agency here who's in control of that, the Environmental Protection Agency. They have spent more than $92 million taxpayer dollars on high-end furniture. Apparently, office furniture like hexagon wooden tables and an $800 pencil drawer was so important. Or just take a look at the huge corporations that are exploiting all of these resources while we're being blamed on the drought and global warming, like Nestle. Nestle boss is saying that he wants to bottle more water in California despite this drought. He said he wants to actually increase the amount of groundwater that's used. And he said, the fact is, if I stop bottling it tomorrow, people are just going to be buying another brand of water. You know, and then we've got investors are mining for water. They're calling it the next hot commodity. So that's what this is all about. This UN agenda, it's not about good feelings and sustainability and kindness and all that. It is about control, and it's about controlling us, the little people, and making us feel guilty for all of it.
Yeah, and one other thing, too, I want to tell you, Alex, and that was when he met privately with the clergy, I believe it was a private meeting in Washington that this quote came out of, but he was talking to the church leaders that were there, and this is what he had to say to them. He said, many of you have suffered greatly in the not-too-distant past by having to bear the shame of some of your brothers who harmed and scandalized the church in the most vulnerable of her members. Did you catch that? The only thing he really had to say about the pedophile controversy within the Roman Catholic Church was, I'm sorry that some of you were embarrassed by being connected with that. He doesn't talk about the heinousness of this. And Alex, when I look at the way
he didn't personalize it, he just said, I'm sorry it embarrassed our thing.
Yes, it embarrassed our institution. I'm sorry because you're part of the institution. But just like we see with the police, they don't purge the evildoers out of their midst. That is how you embrace corruption. That's how you propagate corruption. And I thought it was absolutely outrageous that that's the only thing that we've seen of that. If you want to talk about how you are there to help the children, then do something to help the children. Stop people from killing them and selling their baby parts, and stop people from molesting them sexually. Then we can have a conversation about what else you want to do to protect the children. But people need to understand the thousands, tens of thousands of people, whatever, that are here, they need to understand that this
moral high ground that he has is simply a mask, a facade for a globalist agenda so they can rule the world. And you can see that with the confluence of the Pope and the Chinese president and Obama coming together
on this next step of
global governance.
It's a Pope joins forces with Obama and communist China to take over the world. This is a true axis of eugenics, a true axis of destroying any type of industrialization, clean industrialization around the world. Thank you so much, David Knight.
Well, thank you, Alex.
What began with the disgusting revelations of the British Top of the Pops host Jimmy Savile and his decades of rampant pedophilia, necrophilia, and Satanism has convulsed into a full-fledged unmasking of a three-decades-long callboy ring fueled by government officials, entertainers, government spies, and royal palace workers. The focus of the investigation rests on the West London location known as the Elm Guest House.
Elm Guest House, a former gay brothel where young children are also said to have been molested.
I think Richard's transporting over to the United Kingdom mainland to be abused, rather than just being abused in Northern Ireland, speaks volumes. It ties the two together.
The Elm Guest House, fronted as a gay bathhouse, as numerous victims have attested to, it was primarily a child sex abuse house of horrors for the elite. The revelations are so vast and damaging, the English government was forced to declare the investigation a national security issue. The seedy side of British culture only serves to gain momentum as details emerge of Prime Minister Cameron simulating fornication with a pig during a college occult ritual. And the elite relish their rituals. Hermetic rituals originating from the ancient Egyptian city of Commune, or Hermopolis, a Greek synthesis of the worship of Thoth with that of the Greek god Hermes. Hermeticism reached a cultural metamorphosis in the modern age by several 19th century authors, including Eliphas Levi, Samuel Lytle, MacGregor Mathers, Arthur Edward Waite, and Waite's Golden Dawn nemesis, pedophile, Aleister Crowley. Crowley was quoted as saying, "A made child of perfect innocence is the most suitable victim." And with this sentiment in mind, he set up his Abbey of Thelema in Sicily, Italy. This abbey served Crowley as a laboratory of sex magic, ranging from ritual sacrifice to pedophilia. In 1923, Crowley was booted out of Italy by Benito Mussolini after news of a death at the abbey was reported. Crowley, penniless and a hardcore heroin addict, then landed in France. As ridiculous as it may seem, unconfirmed claims tie the conception of Barbara Bush to the adulterous union of Aleister Crowley and Pauline Pierce, conducted during a sex magic ritual that occurred in France in 1924, possibly making George W. the grandson of the wickedest man in the world, which, if true, would definitely add more weight to the ritualistic events surrounding the tragedy of 9/11. Crowley's rock star-esque influence has spread through entertainment, Freemasonry, and political spheres for decades. It's no wonder that the unnatural and hidden world of pedophilia running rampant within the highest places of power would strive to be finally accepted as a sexual preference by an obligated sycophantic press catering to their globalist pedophile masters to test the moral and ethical waters of the public mind. Superimposed as a grand psyop over Crowley's sickening hidden rituals aggressively being conducted right now from mid-September to mid-November. John Bound for InfoWars.com.
Thanks for watching. That's it for the show tonight. We'll see you here Monday, 7 p.m. Central.
A clean, toxic-free body is the foundation of true health. Introducing Deep Cleanse by InfoWarsLife.com, a scientifically formulated blend of nanocolloidal zeolites and organic ingredients that aid the body in cleansing chemicals and toxic metals. Using our proprietary multi-step extraction technology, Deep Cleanse is our most affordable all-in-one cleanser. With concentrated organic compounds like cilantro, milk thistle, fulvic acid, orange peel, zeolites, and others, Deep Cleanse doesn't hold back. Instead of buying five, six, or even seven different different cleansing products. We use decades-old scientific research to put together the Rolls-Royce of all-in-one cleansing. Look, there's a reason Deep Cleanse is the only product on the market that uses our proprietary Spigyrex herbal processing technique. We use only the highest quality organic herbs backed by serious research, and we still bring it to you at the best price out there. If you wish to find Deep Cleanse and experience the all-in-one cleansing, visit InfoWarsLife.com. That's InfoWarsLife.com or call 888-253-3139.
You are watching the InfoWars Nightly News, which airs 7 p.m. Central at InfoWarsNews.com. And your support is helping us defend liberty worldwide.